Hey everybody, it's John. Just a pre-note to the video that you're about to see. The video that's following was recorded about a month ago. Since that time, I've put a couple of videos out reviewing these collets, and I've also been able to return the ER32 collets because they were just clearly mislabeled. They were metric collets that were labeled imperial collets. The ER25 collets, even though I make some mentions about that they were really no good, the reality is they were only marginally useful at best. But anyway, I hope you get an idea on how to build a collet rack and just disregard some of the comments that I've said about those collets. For the most part, they're all true, but I've already solved that issue. Anyway, thanks for watching as always, and now we'll go on into the video that was recorded about a month ago. Hey everybody, it's John, and welcome on back to the shop for a little short project, very inexpensive project, and that is making a collet rack for about a dollar. Let's go to the Dollar Tree, pick up a little hot plate board for a dollar at the Dollar Tree, spend about 15 minutes putting together a little collet rack for these collets. Join me over here at the workbench. Okay, as I said before, I just thought about making a brief video of this project since it might be helpful for someone out through there, and I've already cut this in two, but this is a picture of the board that I got at the Dollar Tree, and as you can imagine, it was only a dollar. Then what I did, and one reason I do like this particular board is that it did have a border all the way around it. It does kind of make it look a little bit nicer that it's got the border on all four sides. This has a rounded corner in that square, but I don't believe that's going to detract a whole lot from it. Now the collet set that I got, and again, they're just junk. I'm just doing this just as a project because I got to do something with them, either give them away or throw them away or something. But in the meantime, I don't like them laying around. I'm going to make a little bracket for them and give myself some practice. But this set right here, I think it came with a set of, let's see how many I got here, a set of maybe six. I guess it came a set of six. But I'm going to go ahead and make it for nine. And of course, you can get a bigger cutting board if you'd like to make it for more. But in this one right here, I'm just going to space it for nine. Now, the size that I determined the hole needs to be, it needs to be 1 inch and 225 thousandths. It'd be a radius of 612 thousandths. Now, what I'm going to do to drill the hole is I've got one of these little hole drills that I've had for quite a few years, and it does do a pretty nice job of cutting holes in different things. But I'm going to use it after I mark this out for nine equal spaces to go ahead and drill the hole. So I'm going to go ahead and do the layout, and then I'll come back. Okay, I've already got the board laid out, and what I did, I just put a couple of them down here. As you can see, some of them I haven't even taken out of the wrapper. The quality on them was so bad. But the layout I just did with a little Sharpie pen, and the dimensions that I used for the ER32, my board is 8 1/4 this way and 5 1/2 this way, so I just found the center spot, and then I just started marking out from there. Now I marked 2 inches from each side, and then 1 3/4 on the vertical side. So I'm going to take this over to the drill press, go ahead and put the center drill in it. I'm going to go ahead and center drill out each one of these holes. Okay, I've completed all the circles that I've cut out, and then I just used a little deburring tool to go around the edges to make sure that everything was fitting right. Now, if you're off a little bit and your hole doesn't sit down far enough, you can also use the little edging tool here. I forgot what you call it right now, but anyway, this little gadget right there, deburring tool, to actually move that out just slightly if you don't have a drill bit that just exactly fits it. And I have mine sticking up. It's probably in over a little halfway, and they're sticking up probably a half inch from the end. But anyway, that's how you put all of that together. Now you've got to, and again, I'm not building furniture here. I'm just making something for the shop to put this stuff in. So I've got some 1 1/2 pine that I had over there. So now it's just a matter of putting this on some 1 1/2 pine. And I've got some number 6 screws here, so I'm just going to pop those in real quick. Well, let me get back in the frame here. There you go. So I got these number 6s. Going to pop them in real quick.
And I suppose at this time, if you were so inclined, you could take that over to the belt sander and round those corners off so that it would match that. But I'm just putting them in the toolbox. In fact, I've actually made another set for the ER25 collets and went ahead and measured those. So that is an easy way, a very inexpensive way to do that collet holder rack.
Well, I hope you enjoyed that little project right there with those collets. It was really easy. It only takes about 20 minutes to do, and it's very inexpensive. And also, I like the plastic better than the wood or the metal. The metal's not going to scratch. Of course, those collets should be harder. I don't know about these cheap ones or not, but your collets obviously are going to be harder than the metal. But still, you got the noise and everything of those things clanking. I don't particularly like the wood because wood's going to hold moisture. So I think the little plastic hot plate, that's not a hot plate, that's a cutting board. I should have said cutting board on this whole time. But that little cutting board deal is made out of some kind of plastic, probably cheap plastic, but nevertheless, it's not going to hold moisture and doesn't rattle, and hey, you can't beat it for a dollar. So I hope you got something out of this. I'm sure you'll find ways to make things better, and if you did, put it in the comments below. Hope you got something out of that. Hope you learned something. We'll see you back here in the shop from the Upper East Side of Texas. This is John. We're going to catch you on the next video.